So we have a, what happened here? Why do we have a metro station that's not connected to anything? Something must have happened. But I don't know what it is. Let's go ahead and just connect that up. Hey, Swamp Hopper, thanks for the sub. Or the resub, in fact. So, mostly the same mods as last time, although I did add in, hey, Migs Shanix, thanks for the sub. I did add in that this mod that lets you turn off turns. Like, for example, if I clicked on this road and went enable lane control, I could then... Oops, I guess I have to left click. Yeah, I could make it so that people can't make a left turn from this road into there. Which offers some interesting additional road control. Hey, Danuge! Thanks for the resub. We've got a Danuge Island over here. Kirk Solo, hello, hello. Look at all the boats we've got. It's a good thing boats don't really get traffic jams, not like trains. Danuge Island over there. You over here, Gouter, requested that I actually remove the PSN part. Just have Gouter Industrial Park, so I'm going to do that. We've got Katie Cat Industrial Park over here as well. Yabushido Park. Snox 91 Oil Field. We don't have names for these little areas. We're going to have to do one of those. Hello, Exile Magpie. Where's the... There's the region mode and that. And then the big selector. Yeah. We'll just paint this island up. Nerd for All Seasons. What a great name. Hello, hello. Thanks for the continued support. Actually, that's a new sub. I was like, I was sure I've seen that name before, but apparently I are wrong. The Mr. Delusional. Hey, hey. Thanks for the sub. All right, this is Briar Rose Park. We're going to rename that. I'm actually going to get my sub list, randomize it, and then we will name some of these sections off of, or not off of people, based on people. Sexy player. 96. You know what would have been sexier if it had been 69. Just saying, you know, something to think about for the future. Boop, boop, boom. So we're going to have, randomize this list. Boom and boom. We're going to have, this is going to be, Hex the Dark Island. There we are. Hex the Dark Island. Joe Watson, thanks for the resub. Or no, the new sub and Soda Cycle for the resub. Came in right at the same time there. Beginning of the stream is always a little chaotic, but I don't mind. All right, so we got a tons of cash. We got a tons of cash. We roaded up this island over here last time. It's a shame that some of this bit extends outside of our buildable area. We have gone and unlocked all 25 tiles because we've got the mod for that and we've got tons of money going in. So I think we'll work on this. Do we just want to do like a big box select zone and then figure things out? Do we want to accordion up more of the stuff here? There's a lot of empty space here. I think it's probably a good idea to do that. Maybe. Do we want to have like a bunch of roads going this way as well? Or just the accordion strings? I think it probably makes sense to have some more. We could actually have a like a classic grid inside of this. This sort of loopy ends, but then a strict grid. I don't know. Hey, Heard of Scotland. Thanks for the sub. If this were like the Geek and Sundry stream, you'd be dancing like crazy. I don't know if I've watched the Geek and Sundry stream itself, but I've been watching a lot of Felicia Day streaming lately. And yeah, they do little dances. That's it. I can do the fusion core dance from StarCraft. Look at me. I'm a wannabe day 9. Well, who doesn't want to be day 9? All right, let's so I'm just trying to decide if I want to freeform draw some roads that follow this outline or if I want to have a square grid inside. You know, like they both have an interesting potential here. Know what I mean? Pearl. I guess we'll set up a guideline this way. You might ask yourself, who's Earl? I don't know. Earl is whoever you want him or her to be. Maybe Earl is a ruler over in Scotland. See, like the idea of a regular grid inside of such an irregular little street area? It's kind of interesting to me. like the fact that it's not exactly the same. There we go. We are going to have to create a few more connections. Oh, did I switch? I switched. Mortal sin right there. We're going to have to create a couple more connections. Now, especially with our ability to do things like ban left turns now, it becomes a lot less painful to provide a few more of these connections like this. Yeah, day 9 is hilarious because he's so bad at City Skylines. Well, here's, I mean, the thing to remember is, like, everyone is new at everything at some point. And most people who get started doing YouTubing or streaming or whatever do it because, you know, they're particularly good at something and they want to do it, and then they gain a following based on that skill. But then people want to see them play all kinds of different games, right? And they're like, okay, well, I don't have, you know, I put in, if you're day 9, I probably put in 10,000 hours playing StarCraft. And now people want me to play some City Skylines, so it's like, okay, well, I don't have time to put 10,000 hours into this, so I guess I'm just gonna go in blind and hope that doesn't go too bad. Which really explains a lot, I think. Macavity! Are you a Jellico cat? Thanks for the sub! Right? Is that how it's spelled? You know, the cat from Cats? Oh, I didn't leave myself the little guide over here. Maybe over here, just for the tip, we'll go ahead and loop it in there. It's actually going to mostly overlap some the construction zone. That is awkward. Kind of like the idea, but nope. Hate it. Do I want to do one of these? That's the question with these little endy bits. I mean, we can just leave little dead ends, basically, and that's fine. There we are. With the, while we do have two close intersections over here, the fact that there's this little crooked line should prevent people from using this as a shortcut to go through. I mean, it doesn't really go anywhere. It should all be local traffic all the time, which is really our goal, generally speaking. Even here, it's okay for us to create a little bit more intersection there. I think this road structure will be pretty good. I think most of the traffic inside here will all be local, and they will prioritize going out to our 6-lane road. We're going to see how it goes. We've got a lot of demand for commercial. So I guess we'll start... maybe we'll get some water over here. I know, there's a lot of infrastructure work to set up a new island. That's alright. I guess I can do the... Oh, that's actually not quite minimal. It worked out in this case. Normally the trick is to go to 5 or 440. And it's got just a scooch of overlap. I mean, it's only really a problem if you're trying to save a couple of bucks. Not really the end of the world. Your water pipes don't have that much maintenance cost. But it can also be kind of satisfying. Okay, I'm going a little too far off here. I don't need to water the water. Easy does it. Alright, there we go. Alright, I'm going to leave the rest for after, because we're just zoning this area here for now. And then we'll run some power across to there. And I'm actually going to do one of my little things. We're going to get a plaza outfit in this area here. Where's the... Oh, yeah, I got the sunken plaza. Can I get it to fit in here? Yep. What's the cost on it? Oh, it's totally reasonable. Okay, good. So that doesn't connect. So we have to put something on the other side. Skate park. Boom. All right, that connects up that. Okay. No aliens who won then? Any chance of RimWorld livestream in the future? Maybe. Use two lanes as often as possible so you don't get traffic lights. Yes, I've espoused that constantly. People are always like, oh, four lanes and this and that. No. Two lanes as often as possible. No traffic lights. It's awesome. Although someone is working on a mod that gives you even more intersection control. So what you can do is you can turn traffic lights on and off at an intersection and find, like, from a certain area, there's, like, a stop sign and then there's through. So here we can turn off the traffic lights, make this the main road, and then put a stop sign over here for the traffic. That's pretty cool. Doubly so if we then also go and ban left turns here. So you can come here and then take a right and then basically not inflict any sort of like slowdowns. But from this road, you can go ahead and cut through into there. That'll be really awesome. All right. I'm just trying to figure out where I want my, like, how I want my commercial to look. Do I just want it on the outside here and then zone a bunch of residential indoors? We could start with that. Because I'm not seeing this as being a downtown. Especially, it's going to need a fair deal of delivery trucks, so... Although, that can slow down the six-lane traffic quite a bit. Let's zone the outside here, not too much. There's a lot of commercial demand, so they should flow in relatively quickly, which should connect the power. Unless I'm lying to you. No, there we go. Oh, we need some services here, too. That will really, really help things out. We will have to find a spot on this island to tuck in an incinerator. It might even be something like this. Although then there might get traffic problems. Where are we going to put... No, incinerator is on the other side. That's what we want to do. There and there. Do you have water? No. There we go. Get one of those. They're not connected to the grid, but that's fine. They power themselves. Big hospital. Not too much in the middle. Even though it's got nice coverage with our hospital, we want to make sure, actually down here, because ambulances from here might go and service other parts of town, so we want to make sure they can get to the main road pretty easily. The same thing sort of applies to hearses, although maybe less so. I think what we'll do is tuck in one there and then one over there. That'll be good. Big fire station. Same sort of thing, relatively close to one of the road edges, even though the coverage gets a little bit funny. And then we'll put one over here for police station. Okay, so they're not going to be connected to power quite yet, but as soon as the zones start to kick in, they will. We get some public transit in here as well, which will encourage people to move in, but I think this is going to be a fine start. Maybe what I'll do is I'll actually use some low-density commercial sort of in the middle here. That way, when our residences come in, they won't have to travel quite as far to go shopping, which will also help minimize some amount of traffic. And then what I want to do now is grab the marquee tool and just, like, make a huge residential area. I'm just going to try not to clip the other island. We'll do that. People are moving in right away. There's not a ton of residential demand, but there's technically a little bit, and there's a decent number of services over here. We will have to get more parks in here in a second. Actually, I suppose we can start on that now. What is this thing? Public soccer field. Yeah. Oh, it's too big. Who knows? I want a soccer field. I'm going to put it over here. I'm going to put it here. That way, I'm going to know for sure I'm not going to continue this T-junction through, which will be good. Now, where are my big parks at? That's not the one I'm looking for, although it's certainly fine. Oh, no, I can't fit this one in here. All right. Really? Well, I guess that's okay. Most of these parks won't be powered yet. But these houses, these buildings... Oh, this is actually the commercial area that's popping in. These guys will be powered. We just got to wait for the buildings to come in. And they will come in. Let's let it run for a little while. Bum, 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 bum. Ah, bloody doors off. Bloody doors off? I don't know. Yes, you saw something about the Sudbury Neutrino Observatory. Very cool. I've actually been down there. It's very awesome. Back when it was still under construction. Like, ages ago. God, so long ago. Like, 20 years ago. Mm-hmm. It's a very cool place with some really awesome science. I think it's only one of two heavy water neutrino observatories. I think there's one in Japan that uses the same sort of technique. All right. I'm just waiting very impatiently for more of these buildings to pop in so that so that these buildings all get connected. I suppose what I should actually do, though, is put in a little bit... so all this housing over here? Yeah, this is not good. This should all be offices, because offices aren't bothered by noise pollution as much. And they're adjacent to some high-density... high-density commercial, which is noisy. If you use the paint bucket tool to dezone, you'll often get little bits left over. So you don't want to do that. You want to use the brush or the marquee tool. And I particularly like the marquee tool. And I think it's because it's mostly just at these corners. When you got a nice square grid, who dat? Xanth, hey, thanks for the resub. When you got a nice square grid, it's not an issue. But it's these corners, and I think what happens is there's sort of multiple tiles from each one of these roads. That's why there's sort of these blank bits, and they're still there, so they're still sort of getting zoned. So then when you dezone, you only dezone some of it. So when you use the marquee tool or the paintbrush tool, because it's an area thing as opposed to the paint bucket, I think it's just much, much better at clearing out even the invisible tiles. I assume that'll be an issue, a bug they fix at some point. Okay, well, we can probably get people to come in here a little bit faster if we go ahead and... Oh, we don't have schools down. I stopped short. We do need to get some schooling over here. One of those. One of those. Also, by being ploppables, they can help connect up some of the power grid a little sooner. There we go. Everything's connected up now. That should help. But yes, let's get some public transit in our new area. So we are going to get a metro. Say there. Right over there. This just feels good when I don't have to bulldoze something to get it done. And over there. I think the three connections is going to be perfectly fine for now. Like that. And... I guess we'll connect it to this system this way. Reska! Thanks for the sub! So we're going to get a local line here. And we'll get another line over here. There we go. I got some mods for the lines as well. If I go to public transit, right, and I click on, say, my subway over here. Okay, some of the text is a little bit long. And I got part of this mod also auto-renames some of the new lines, which is why you get some good descriptions about where they reach when you've got zones. They will name the lines based after that, which is nice. We can get a bunch more stats, which is cool. You can deselect one and then just look at it. All right, I think if I click on it, it'll zoom. No. Not quite, but I can get some extra info. Sick thought, thanks to resub. Anyway, handy little dandy tools. I'm going to have to, like, every 2 weeks, I'm going to have to put out a new video listing all my latest mods. All right, people are coming. I mean, the city's still growing. A lot of the other houses haven't been dealt with yet. This is kind of all kinds of bad. And I think that's why there's sort of bad healthcare going on here. They even got a crematorium over there, but I'm thinking they're having trouble getting in and out. I'm going to go ahead and plop one down over here. It's, having it nearby doesn't mean that they're going to get serviced first. These hearses will go all over town to pick up people. We do have one here. We got quite a lot of hearses picking up people over here, so hopefully that'll happen soon. But this is not good. And we know that this happens with cargo trains, with cargo terminals. They can generate a little too much traffic, and this should not be on a major thoroughfare. Although, I mean, this doesn't feel like it should be a major part of town. But okay, no, that's, wow. Huh. Alright, well, yeah, okay. That is somewhat less than good. Wow. Emmerich, thanks for the resub. Wow. I don't want to move the cargo train terminal because it'll be a pain to set up. Well, not really, actually. I don't have to reset up the lines or anything, so maybe it's not that much of a pain. But what I'm thinking of is moving the road, basically. Just ensuring that it's local traffic only here. Or I could make a pair of one-ways. Actually, that might be the best way and least disruptive. If I go ahead and just upgrade this to a one-way. Wait, you can't upgrade a bridge? Also, this is going the wrong way. You can't upgrade a bridge to a one-way? Alright, that's fine. Then we bulldoze this. And connect it up. Okay. And then obviously we've got to let people back onto the island. What I'm going to do is get rid of this road. And instead, from here, do one of those. Which probably means this can be upgraded to a two-way, though, just so we can service this area over here. We'll do one of those. Whew. Hey, the Wacky Viking. Thanks for the resub. So, this will take a while, because, first of all, a lot of people are doing U-turns right now. Like, they're still working things out. Oh, they're doing big lane changes, too. Because if they're going from here to here, they're going to want to change lanes to over there. I think I just got to bulldoze this area and rebuild it. I don't think the solution is one of these, but I don't know. We'll give it some time. And then anyone who wants to get to the station from over here is doing a huge U-turn, which is not good. Not good at all. Chipperson, thanks for the sub. So, I think part of it is the station is just in a crummy area. If I ran the station like this, up and down instead, with a one-way that connects up here, and could even loop back into the industrial area, that would save a lot of traffic. But, you know, I probably shouldn't overthink it too much. This might fix it, but I think we would do better. You don't want this on a main road. You want it on its own offshoot with its own sort of traffic pattern. But if all I do is sort of provide an alternative here, people will still mostly use this road. So it really has to be out of the way. So that's what I'm thinking. If it was over here, oriented this way, with a local one-way that runs here. Actually, especially if it was at a bit of an angle, because that way people who are trying to leave the city will mostly use this. They won't use this for local routes. That will be the thing. All right, let's get cracking on that. So this will probably get replaced at some point. Just because it looks stupid and annoys me. Pause. I'm getting blablunged. Oh, thank you. I forgot to make an adjustment to my scene. I always normally do this. There we go. There we go. Sorry about that. I forgot to correctly arrange my scene here. Yes. No, I didn't want to do that. Well, I guess I have to at least bulldoze the bridge because apparently you can't replace it. I want this to go back to being a two-way that hooks up our subway once more, which is good. Then we're going to pull back on this because we're going to have to make sure to bring it down to ground level at a slightly different rate. We'll have to rebuild our power connection at some point. So my idea here is to use a one-way, first of all, because with these terminals, you often want to use a one-way because just because of the traffic coming in and out of the terminal is a pain. So, thinking something like this, and then cargo terminal a little further out. That way it'll give us the ability to maybe bend in and still connect up over here. Now, let's see here. It'll be interesting to sort of pass a road under there for the bridge work I want to do. Although, it might be easier if the rail were flat and then the road went up. I think that would indeed be the case. kind of liked having the rail parallel. Maybe it still will be. Actually, maybe I shouldn't bulldoze that much. I always look for the rail in the road tool instead of the public transit tool. Because if we come off this way, we can still... do one of those. That's not so bad. And then from here... connect through. Clindos, thanks for the resub! And then from here, the one-ways. Can they fit there? Yeah. Go up and over. Yep, that's acceptable. Or you can go the other way. Depending on where you want to go. We'll definitely have to rebuild those power connections. Are. There. I think that will be much better. Now, we don't have our power anymore, so let's go ahead and do that. Look at that, guys. Bet you didn't think I would remember. I didn't think I would remember. Alright, let's let this play. Oh, the railroad's... No, you've got power. You're fine. So this is a two-way. This is potentially redundant. Or at the very least, doesn't need to be this fat. We could go ahead and skinnify this thing up and it'd probably look much, much better. But now, what's really important is that cars coming in and out of this won't block the main avenue. We definitely have to wait like 3-4 minutes for this to clear up. Absolutely. It will take a little while because there's a big backlog. But that's why there's like dead bodies here, is because the hearses couldn't get there. And it was all because of this. But now, there, if we take a look at these trucks, they will no longer have to sort of fight for the merger. Because no one's going to be driving through this, or very few people will be driving through this. So anyone who is leaving here, who wants to go to the industrial park, should instantly be able to merge into the right lane. And there's a nice split over here, which is good. I don't like the fact that we've complicated this intersection a little bit more. One of the trucks just gave up and taken too long to get through. But I think it will clear itself pretty quickly. Push comes to shove, I'm not sure what else we would do. I think it's going to be fine, but again, at this point here, there's still a backlog. A lot of this backlog here will end up moving and changing and doing weird things. Oh, see. Okay, no, you're going there. Oh! Alright, it's a little unoptimal. I just realized it's much better to have the one way go the other way. Or... why do you go in there? Oh, that's actually really annoying. So yes, it's actually better to have the one way going the other way. I didn't realize people come in over here. Now, with our structure, I don't think it would have been better. I think it would be worse. But this backlog eventually will resolve itself. The problem is this line. We've got to wait. And we might get a death apocalypse on our hands just because of the amount of traffic that is backlogged. We've got hearses stuck in here. Look, there's one. See? There's tons of hearses that are just stuck in this insanity. Look how far the traffic is backlogged over here. Is that another hearse? Yep. Right there. Let's find more. There's one! There's another one! There's another one! And another one. People aren't getting sick and dying. They're just dying because of old age, and then they're not getting picked up. Now, they might spread a little bit of a plague, but hopefully it'll be okay, yeah. All these cars trying to get out, not able to in a timely manner. I wonder, if I ran a one-way from here to here, would people use this as a shortcut out of town? I guess they would, which is not what I want. I just wanted to provide a slightly easier way for them to get here. Alright, let's come back to that. So, let's check out new land over here. Definitely a need for some workers. Mostly uneducated. They're moving in a little slow right now, just because I think they're having some difficulty with, you know, the amount of death that's going on. And who can blame them, really? Let's get some more offices over here, just to give people a few more work options. Nice thing about offices is they don't add much in the way of traffic, although they don't provide any goods for our commercial either. We're going to split this island into a few different neighborhoods here. Let me load up the subscriber list and see who should we name this after. You know, we should start naming the bridges. That would be fun too. Zenri Other. Well, it's already a square, so we'll leave square as a name. It was something square. It's a huge bridge. We should name this after someone. Oh, it's part of the Snox oil field. But I think what I can do is put just a wee hole in here. Actually, as long as I start it. There we go, the Florence District. A little crooked. I didn't realize the region tool seems to snap to roads. That's cool. I don't think I realized that. This is going to be... This is the crazy German 03 bridge. There we are. And we'll have to wait quite some time for that traffic to clear up. If I noticed I'm floating. No. Oh, because I'm making multiple adjustments. Damn it. All I want is this for look good. All I want is for this for to look good. Now, I think in time, it's very easy to imagine that this road here will reach out there. Who dat? Doroth! Thanks for the resub! Something like that. And this actually will probably alleviate some traffic, because some of the cars will almost certainly take this route instead to get over here. I like this loop. Looks cool. Looks very cool. This intersection, or this corner, is like a little bit slowy-downy, but that's alright. There's quite a bit of trains waiting to go through. This is the end point. Like, we've got a continuing. We're actually going to have to make sure that we provide a siding for later. Let's go ahead and do that now, just sort of future-proof it. And make sure, yeah, we can go under that road. Good. Come around a little bit further. Tell me you can connect over here. Okay, so not that then. Instead, there we go. Cool. Looks like an interchange. We won't need this now, but later on, there'll be more rail connections over there, and we want to make sure we can bypass the station. God, this station is super mega busy. I can't believe how many trains are coming down here. That's part of the reason there's so many traffic problems. However, speaking of traffic problems, they're starting to clear up. Now, we do have a lot of intersections here, which is slowing down some of this. Look at all the scooters. It's amazing. Now, that's got to stay there. And that's... Well, it doesn't, actually. This is a one-way in. And this is a one-way out. No, it's a two-way. Be better if it was a one way out. Not particularly, because that would still create an intersection there. We can't avoid this intersection because of that, and obviously this one has to be here. Well, what might ameliorate things will require a little bit of bulldoze here, but that doesn't matter because this doesn't actually connect anything. We just put it in there to future-proof. Is we could connect like that. And then if these I can ban left turns here now. Which I like a lot. Now it'll still make an intersection. And there's no way to avoid that. Right. If these are one ways, does it stop an intersection? It does, actually. If they're one ways off. If they're one ways in, I think you still get it. But one ways off, which is fine here. There we go. We can leave that one. Okay, so there'll be an intersection here, but this is no longer a controlled intersection. Why don't I just get rid of this connection completely? Let's do that. Oops. Actually, that's fine. Zorts! Hey! Thanks for the resub, Zorts! So this is back to being a two-way. Also, Cyrilatish. Thanks for the resub. Hit that there. Just there. Just stop short. And maybe message. So this is now a two-way. There we go. So, I mean, there was no traffic intersection there anymore, but it stopped certain amounts of optimization. Mailier, I missed you! Oh, actually, I suppose I could trim some more intersections away. Do that just as a guideline. I gotta pause, grab... Reconnect. Get rid of that little bit. And then I can do that. And then same thing here. If I connect it up that way, I can remove this bit and just get it like that. There we go. I'm also hoping this will encourage people to use more lanes instead of just the middle one. I should un-one-way this thing. Now, apparently, you can't upgrade this bridge. Can I change it to a different type? No. Well, that makes me sad. Just a regular two-lane road here should be more than sufficient. Just to provide a little bit of an extra little flow. Just reduces a little bit of the pressure over here. But it doesn't need any crazy amount of lanes. Oh, I say that. It does have a cargo harbor. I forgot about that. This is a one-way here. Come in here. Well, most cars will come in that way. That should ultimately be okay. Alright, traffic is definitely improving. Again, if we just give it time, it'll mostly go and clear itself up. At this point, this is the biggest bottleneck. I don't know where these guys are going, though. Oh, over here. Well, okay, I guess that's legit. Now, I could ban left turns over here. But then, there really wouldn't be a convenient way to get from here to over there. You have to go through this, like, way far over there. Although, instead of connecting here, what I could do is force the traffic up and around this way. Right, force it down here, and then it would only be making, well, I could provide an alternate route, is what I'm trying to say, so that anyone trying to get here wouldn't have to hit this highway. Make almost like a mini exchange. For example, if I just connected from here to somewhere around here. Because a lot of these trucks, they're taking so long to get through. Again, part of it is because there's still a giant bottleneck, although it's not as giant as it used to be. Once this goes away, they won't have as much of a hard time making that left turn. But this is, you know... It's not like this wouldn't work. So, again, the existing traffic won't be affected, but new cars that spawn and want to go in this direction should use this little one-way. I can really only use the one lane, so I could have used an actual overpass line. Let's come back to that and see how it goes. I think we're okay. Our death problems are still somewhat there. How many dead people do we have? 700 actually is not impossible to deal with. And we have the auto bulldoze tool, so that we're not going to have like our city values plummet or anything. Do you not have water over here? You don't have water over there. Look at that. So we're going to have to build a new water pump soon. Why not build it down here? Water is nice and clean. It should have basically unlimited amounts of it. Build a pair. Like that. And we'll have to get a little power line as well. I think just until maybe these buildings pop in, then it might be all right. I got to stop obsessing over that traffic. We've got to let the existing traffic resolve itself, and then we'll be fine. Commissariat, thanks to the resub. Dun, 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 dun. Wow, lots of people apparently being kind of jerkasses going on. Do, 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 do. Get out them banhammers. All right, we can probably start to develop the other area. Still a lot of demand for commercial. So what I think I'm going to do here... I think I want to avoid